where to start at the beginning. You were born in Honolulu, but you were brought up in Sydney, and you were quite a precocious reader, I think.
I did start voraciously reading when I was little, and partly because I was so fair, I wasn't allowed to go to the beach. And I hated being fair-skinned. I so badly wanted dark skin. But because of that, I would stay indoors and I would read. And through reading became my love of characters and my ability to sort of enter into the characters that I was reading was there from a very early age.
Do you think films can change things?
Shining light onto things or even putting it out into the conversation, raising people's awareness. Yeah, all of those things go into whether they immediately change things or whether they slowly drip, drip, drip change things. I believe in the power of storytelling or art to change the world. Absolutely.
The strength of television at the moment, and it is so strong, and you're one of the producers of Big Little Lies. Do you feel that threatens theatrical cinema at all?
I think a lot of people watch television now, but there's something wonderful about going to the cinema and sitting with a big group of people and watching a film together. I still do it. It would be such a pity for that to get lost.
If you look at the evidence on screen, you would say that women do seem to be getting wider range of roles, that there seem to be more women directing. I mean, it's happening slowly, slowly. What's your feeling? What's your gut feeling about it?
I always just look at the statistics.
Yeah.
The statistics are not good. It was about 11% for female directors, isn't it? Which, you know, I made a pledge a couple of years ago to work with a female director every 18 months.
Nicole Kimmel, thank you for your life in pictures.
Thank you. Thank you so much.